This is the dissection of the anterior triangle of neck. The anterior triangle of neck is bounded medially by the anterior median line of neck from chin up to the sternum. Laterally, this is the anterior border of sternocleidomastoid muscle, and the base superiorly, it is formed by the base of mandible and the line joining angle of mandible to mastoid process. So this triangle here is the anterior triangle of neck. Further, in this triangle we can see two muscles. This muscle here is the digastric muscle having two bellies. This is the anterior belly of digastric muscle, and this is the posterior belly of digastric. Lying along the posterior belly of digastric muscle, there is another muscle here. This is the stylohyoid muscle. So here there is posterior belly of digastric and stylohyoid muscle. This is the anterior belly of digastric. This is the hyoid bone here. Below the hyoid bone, we can see this is the superior belly of omohyoid. If we reflex sternocleidomastoid, we can see the omohyoid muscle having two bellies. This is the superior belly, and this is the inferior belly of omohyoid. Medial to superior belly of omohyoid, this muscle here in the same plane as omohyoid, this is sternohyoid muscle. From sternum to hyoid bone. So medially sternohyoid, laterally is the superior belly of omohyoid. Now the digastric muscles, anterior belly, posterior belly, and the superior belly of omohyoid further divide the anterior triangle into four smaller triangles. The first triangle, which is situated here in the midline, this triangle is the submental triangle. This is actually a single median triangle which is divided into two halves, left half and right half. On either side we can see the anterior belly of the digastric muscles of the left and right sides. The base is formed by the hyoid bone, and the apex is at the chin. So this median triangle here is the submental triangle. The floor of this triangle is formed by this muscle. So this muscle here is the mylohyoid muscle. The right and the left mylohyoid muscle form a median raphe. This median raphe is the mylohyoid raphe. So on this side we can see the mylohyoid muscle here, which forms the floor of the submental triangle. The second triangle here, this is the digastric triangle or submandibular triangle, which is bounded antero-inferiorly by the anterior belly of digastric, postero-inferiorly by posterior belly of digastric and the stylohyoid muscles, superiorly by the base of mandible and the line joining angle of mandible to mastoid process. So this is the submandibular or digastric triangle, whose main content is this gland here. This is the submandibular salivary gland. The third triangle here is the muscular triangle between hyoid bone and the sternum, whose boundaries are medially is the anterior median line of neck from hyoid to sternum. And here, posterosuperiorly is the superior belly of omohyoid, and posteroinferiorly is the anterior border of the lower part of sternocleidomastoid muscle. So this triangle is the muscular triangle, whose main contents are the infrahyoid muscles. The infrahyoid muscles are 1. Sternohyoid medially, the omohyoid muscle whose superior belly is seen here, lateral to it, deep to sternohyoid. On this side we can see In a deeper plane, there is sternothyroid in the lower part and thyrohyoid in the upper part. So there are four infrahyoid muscles, sternohyoid, omohyoid, and deep to them, sternothyroid and thyrohyoid. The last triangle here is the carotid triangle, which is bounded antero inferiorly here by the superior belly of omohyoid. Superiorly here, there is a posterior belly of digastric and stylohyoid muscles, and behind here is a anterior border of sternocleidomastoid. So this triangle here is a carotid triangle. The floor of the carotid triangle is formed by middle constrictor and inferior constrictor muscles, and the main content of the carotid triangle are the common carotid artery medially, internal jugular vein lateral to it, between and behind them here is the vagus nerve. This is the vagus nerve. More superficially, we can find here the ansa cervicalis, which mainly supplies the infrahyoid muscle except thyrohyoid. The common carotid artery is dividing here into internal carotid and the external carotid arteries. So this is the carotid triangle. So these are the four subdivisions of the anterior triangle of neck.